Hey there, my name is Drew Brashler, and in this video, I want to show you how to use the eMotion LV1 Classic Mixer from Waves on an already set up Dante network and have the LV1 be a secondary mixer on the Dante network. Now, if you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident with your production gear no matter where you're starting from. So let's go ahead and dive in. Now, I have my LV1 Classic here from Waves, and I'm super excited about this console, but what if we want to set up this console on a Dante network that already has Dante mixers? So I have a Dante network set up, and it already has a mixer, and it is set as primary on that Dante network. And I'm just wanting to add this in maybe to a broadcast situation or a monitor desk, that sort of thing. So there is one device that lets us convert Dante to Wave Sound Grid. And that's the Hear Technologies WSG Bridge. And so it's a Waves bridge that connects Waves Sound Grid with Dante. And this device can do 64 inputs and 64 outputs via the two network interfaces. So we have Waves on one side, Dante on the other. And it allows it to talk over those two protocols together with really, really low latency. Now, the WSG Bridge works at sample rates from 44.1 all the way up to 96K. So depending on what sample rate your Dante network is set in, you can run this WSG Bridge. So on the back of the bridge, we have two network ports. We have one network port for our WSG, and that goes and connects into the back of our sound grid network on the back of the LV1 Classic. And so here is the magic box. This is the Hear Tech WSG Bridge. And so on the front of this unit, we have basically a power switch and a clock select. And the clock select is important because when we have this on A, this is set to take our clock source from the Dante card. If we have this set to B, it's set to have the clock source coming from our sound grid network. Now, because we are adding our LV1 Classic into an already existing Dante network, I'm wanting to take my clock source off of my Dante network, which is A. Now, moving to the back side of this thing, we have a couple different things. We have our power supplies, we also have our Dante card, which has a primary and a secondary input, and then we have our WSG card. Now, on these cards, obviously we would be setting up our WSG into our sound grid ports on the back of the LV1 Classic. And then on the Dante side, we would connect our primary up to the primary side of our Dante network and the secondary to our redundant secondary network on Dante if we have that existing. So I'm going to go ahead and pop this back into my network here and get this connected. So on my Dante network, I have a Yamaha DM3, and that is set to the preferred master. And then obviously the bridge is set as a follower to the leader. So it's just following that master clock of the DM3. Now, on the LV1 Classic, I have went ahead and connected the two devices. So I have my Hear Tech plugged into the WSG on the back of my LV1 mixer. And we can go into setup, and then we can drop down and find our network devices. And here is the Hear Tech SoundGrid bridge. So I can go ahead and open that up. Now, if I leave this Classic mixer on master, what's going to happen is I can hear audio from my Hear Tech bridge, but the clock is not going to match up. So if I push up volume on one of the channels that I'm pulling in, it's going to drop audio periodically, which obviously is not good. And so let's go ahead and actually hear what that sounds like. So I have my channel 1, and I'm going to pull in from my 1 and 2 on the Hear Tech, and we can go ahead and pull this up. So this is just pink noise, and there's the drop. So at some point, as things are going, you are going to have audio drops, and that's because we haven't synced the desk clock to match what the Dante network is. Now remember, we set that selector switch on the front of the Hear Tech bridge to be on 1, which means that it's pulling its master clock from the Dante card, which is the way that we want this, because we are setting up this mixer as secondary to the Dante network with the Dante mixer of the DM3 being the primary. So in my setup, what I need to do is I need to drop down into the HearTech bridge and set this as master, being the HearTech sound bridge as the master clock. Now, what this is going to do is this is going to sync everything on the Waves sound grid network to be pulling its clock from the Dante bridge, the Dante sound grid bridge of the HearTech. And so we can see that this is the M, which means that it is the master to the sound grid network. So again, we have our DM3 as primary on the Dante network. That is then feeding into our Dante to sound grid bridge. And on that sound grid bridge, the sound grid side of that is the master for the sound grid network. Now, if I go and pull up my audio from this channel, it is just going to continue being correct because now my sound grid network is pulling its clock from the Dante bridge. Now, what's great about this Dante bridge is I have the ability of having 64 channels bidirectionally, so inputs and outputs, from my sound grid network to the Dante network, which is fantastic. So I can go into patch and I can pull up all my patches of all of my 64 inputs that I have available to me on my HearTech. And then on the output side, I also have 64 outputs available to me on this HearTech bridge. Now, if 64 wasn't enough, all we would have to do is just add one more of our sound grid to Dante bridges, and then we would be able to get 128 channels. If that's not enough, then you can add another one. But remember, the LV1 Classic has the ability of doing 64 channels, mono or stereo. So that would give us 128 sources. So if you wanted to take all 128 sources into 64 stereo channels on your LV1 Classic, you would want to get two of these Dante bridges from HearTech. Now, obviously, the flexibility of having this is huge. We have the ability of adding the LV1 Classic as a broadcast mixer, or we could add it as a monitor mixer if we wanted to. Or if we had a monitor desk and we were just relying on that as the primary for the Dante network, and then we wanted to have the LV1 Classic at front of house, we could also do that. So not only is this great for adding into a system, but if you are upgrading from, say, a Yamaha console and have a bunch of Rios already set, then all you have to do is just get one of these Dante bridges, and then you can use your existing Dante network for our input and output of our LV1 Classic. Now, the only caveat is you would not be able to control the gains of your Rios from the LV1. So you would need to use like Yamaha remote for being able to control the gains, or have a Yamaha desk and be controlling the gains via that. Now, I hope this video is helpful for you today. If you do happen to have any questions, or there's a video that you're hoping that I would make on the LV1 or Waves or anything like that, please post that in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. If you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day.